you grab
Girls, y'all gotta lose the straight hair so that your hair, you really can't tell if it's messed up or not. It's quite convenient. So, here's what we're doing tonight. We're gonna make some little wraps, and this is how easy it is. I've got my pack of no salted, no sea salt nori wraps from the Asian store. Every time I go in there, they look at me like I'm a freak, because you know I'm so tall, and oh, hello, you beautiful lady, which is nice, but they're always, I don't know, like I'm an alien coming in there. So, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna pause this a minute because I just can't play.
You hit me like the sky fell on me, and I decided you look well on me.
I can't get anything done with the songs on. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. I have chopped up some big juicy fat boy tomatoes, my favorite. I have one of these, which I forget the name of this, but it's kind of a mild pepper, sort of like a banana pepper, but a little hotter. And I'm leaving the seeds because I like some spice. And then I have some celery, and what I'm doing is I'm just cutting it in strips like this. I'm cutting my tomatoes in strips. These are so good. They're like candy. You can eat them by themselves. And I have my peppers cut in strips. See that? Okay. So I have some romaine too. Now these had ends on them. They're a little bit bitter for some reason on the end, like right here. So I just chopped that off, and they look like this, like little cups, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my piece of nori like this. I've showed y'all this before, but until you get used to doing it, there's kind of an easy way to do it. So I don't have a rolling paper or any of that rolling thingy bamboo sheet. So what I do is I'm going to wet about this much of each side, okay? Just in the water. You don't have to be technical about it. Just wet it. Just like, I don't know if y'all can see that. Okay, and then I'm going to take these like this. Okay, and I'm going to put it right in the middle of my nori wrap. See? I wish I had a camera that could aim down here, but see, that's how it looks. Okay, and then I'm going to line it. Those nori sheets smell so good. They make me hungry. I'm going to line it with a few of the, see, they're like slivers so that they stay in there and they don't just, if you chop it up into little bitty pieces, what happens is, as you go to cut it, which I'm going to show you a little trick to that, it will be the easiest thing. You'll think, oh, I should have thought of that. Because sometimes when you go to cut these, the wet side will rip and then your stuff falls out and it's a pain. And then I think, well, I'll just throw it all in a salad bowl and take the wrap in my hand and grab it and throw it in my mouth. But, you know, that didn't look as cute. So, anyway, I'm going to put my peppers in there. And then I'm going to put my celery. And then I'm going to put my long strips of tomato like this. I really like these tomatoes. I mean, they really are like candy. So, it looks like this, okay? And what I'm going to do is I'm fixing to put a little bit of, well, you can either put the dressing in here or you can dip them in there. I think I'll just dip it. So it's just like this. It's just basic. You could add some spices or whatnot, but I don't have any handy, so I won't. I don't really need it. So what you do is you kind of, you bring one side over like this, okay? And then you're just going to roll it over, smooth the other side out. And because it's already wet, see, it's going to stick together. And you just roll it up. And if you need a little more water because it dried out because you were trying to video and dance at the same time as you were trying to cook for yourself, just wet the edge like this. See, that's what it looks like. Okay, and then, now normally people would lay this down and they would cut it and say, have an extra sharp knife. I don't have time to sharpen my knife every dang time. So, what I'm going to use again now is my handy dandy scissors. And I'm just going to cut this. Usually, you can cut it into pieces. Like, you could cut it into little pieces like this, and then that would be all cute, and you could get your chopsticks out and all that. Or you could just, I usually just kind of cut mine at a diagonal, because I'm going to dip these. So, see, they look like this. You can put anything in there. Shiitake mushrooms are good. Are those, I forget their name. They're like little bitty white mushrooms on the end. They have long stems. They're good in there, too. Really cute. See that? Okay, and then this is my same dressing I've been using because I don't have to be stressed. I don't have to make this harder than it is. Okay, so this dressing was dill, chives, red pepper, mango, red pepper. I think that's all I put in it. Let me see. Oh, and I might have put a yellow pepper. So see? And then you could put this in your bowl. I could show you how cute it is. Hold on. I just do a little small serving size, okay? Put your dressing in the bowl. And then you would just have these for dipping. I kind of like something all in one bowl. I'm just sort of lazy like that. See there? It's that easy. I mean, it's quick and easy. And, but before I had that, you can put all kinds of stuff in there too. I really like that combo. It's just really fresh and it digests easy. Which, speaking of that, I'm fixing to come to you with a sprouting video. And I want to taltalk to you about, for example, mung bean sprouts. I was just in the Asian grocery because I was thirsty after school. And sure, I could have stopped by and got a Red Bull. Or I could have got, they keep on advertising in my town, these dollar sweet teas at McDonald's. And they're like, I don't know, they're like 32 ounces. And I think that is not a deal. That's a dollar worth of kill me for cheap, you know. So instead, here's what I did. I had my giant knife that I carry around in the car because you never know. I'm a single girl. It looks like this. Very sharp. And I bought one of these. Okay, of course it didn't have the straw on. I bought it. This is a Thai coconut. Okay, so this was $1.39 at my local Asian grocery. And so I came out to the car and I opened up the back of the car and I set this in my Jeep bed and I hacked it like this. Then I hacked it like this. And then I hacked it like this. And then I took my knife and I pried it open. And then, of course, what else would you have in your car but a metal straw? And I put it in there. Ta-da! Isn't that cute? And it's like vanilla milk. This is the best stuff. I could live on it. If I had plenty of money, I would just drink this for morning, noon, and night. And it would be so good. It's electrolyte rich. And anyway, I'm going to hack this open in a minute. And I'm going to scoop out the coconut meat. And I'm going to make something with that because this is very luscious and delicious. But before I do that, I'm going to have a little appetizer. And I have to warn y'all about this because, you know, sometimes there's drinks you can have and that kind of puts you in a different mood and kind of change your outlook. You know, you could be just not even feeling that cute or, I don't know, just not really in the mood. And I got a drink for you for that, okay? But I'm warning you because this is called Mango Magic. And really, it's the bad girl shot. See that? And I'm having a large. This stuff, it will make you frisky. I don't care who you are. I don't even care if you've got PMS. Which, you know what? I got it. It's around that time. Oh, my birds are in the bird bath. Hey, it's kind of around that time. This is how I feel when I have PMS.